Können auch noch einen Kaffee zu trinken, Herr Ching. So. Ein Winnie. Na, not scared. But interested in the second season. What's new for this game in this season is it have an options menu about resolution and graphics before the game starts. That was really odd. So it's just a sign of improvement. Well, I don't can also consider how the third episode is connected to all. And hello, Groby. How are you doing? Wie geht's? Das German von meinen German Guys. Du hast wahrscheinlich nicht mitbekommen, was in Season 1 passiert ist. Ich hoffe, es gibt ein Recap. Yeah, I have played this game in English because I have tried in this first season the German localization and have fight two failures in the first letter. So why not do it in whole English? So if you're fine with that? I think stream is also... Oh, yes! We get a recap. Jamal David, alerted by the suicide of a mysterious letter of his friend Anthony Beechworth, went in search for memories of his past that he had lost. David discovered that in school he had taken part in a strange experiment. Its goal was to peek through the veil, the thin line between common reality and the world of horror and madness that lies beyond, under watch of an eye of a bird. During his search, he was inoculated with a drug he had used back then. The serum made David's mind travel for a few hours to the dreamlike realm of the veil. There he met his old classmate, Alexandre Dupree, who urged David to join his course and cross with him the realm of the bird. This which Norwegian haven't been at home. I was getting home as you will. Ah, okay. Well, it's okay. I've seen that. I had many clicks in the videos of the last streams. That's I'm proud of. And we get a really short recap. I will take one of myself out of this. And David woke up from his trance. He found himself deeply convinced by his friend's words. He traveled to Dupree's house, where he discovered his friend had dosed himself with a new serum, leaving a catatonic body behind. The new drug was capable of transporting the mind permanently to the veil and beyond. Not good that the skip button is over the text. Finally, David found a vial of his serum and had it injected. He met his friend again in the veil, and together we walked through the last door, entering a world forbidden to human eyes. Oh yeah, the witch therapist Dr. John Wakefield, worried by his patient's disappearance and strange visions, had sought the help of his colleague Professor Johann Kaufmann, an expert in the occult. Searching Anthony Beechworth's house, Wakefield and Kaufmann found a disturbing returned letter in which Anthony had tried to warn Alexander Dupree of what could happen if a door was opened. He feared something from the other side might then come to ours. So, they are coming. So, just my recap. In the first four episodes of season one, we are Jeremiah DeWitt. We have, as it says, there was a letter. And we have visited Beechworth's well, it's simple graphics, but this game has so good story and a good ear for soundtrack. It knows when to play music, it knows to when totally silent, and woof. sometimes with jump scares get me. this whole game is like a love letter to Lovecraft. I really, really like it so far. I think I can make it a bit louder. So. And yeah, the graphics are very simple. The whole thing was a crowdfunding project. So, to recap. So, we have investigated his house, have found that he has hung himself up. His wife was starved because she was crippled and cannot walk alone out of bed. What do you think is don't escape 4 days to survive? This game has nothing to do with it. But there are secret prequels to this game. This is from another developer and just using simple graphics. It's point and click, but you cannot die or something. It's more story driven here. And we are in the year 8091 as a main part time, and our protagonist of the first season, David, has found when a second letter. Okay, nice. He must go to a boarding school to reveal more of his past. When at this boarding school, we found out that it's no school no more. It was a hospital then run by nuns, and the head of this was his old teacher, Father Ernest. After some events with patients and even they find Father Ernest and he talked about us about what happened in the club in the past, that these four people were witnesses of this happening, this godlikely bird from the other side, and when he has burnt himself up, that was really oof. some guy who was really, really crazy and loved dead people has knocked us out and buried us alive. We have found out that he has killed patients and to love them because he is necrophilic. But in the fourth episode we have found out that, or in the extras, maybe in the extras, that we were rescued by the nuns and that this, how was he named? Bradley or something like that. Was caught by the police. But in the third episode, death. Tod. And the third episode was really psychedelic. We were first in the in the foggy part of London. Episode two was in Aberdeen, Scotland. So we don't have an idea how we come there, and we have to do some crazy shit. And as this recap says, it's all to this serum we take, so it was all in, or almost an illusion. And what else? In episode 4, we were at this house of this other friend and witness of this experiment in the past. And it was really catatonic and have read more of this veil and how this serum is supposed to work. And and at the end, or with episode 4, we are now David is now part of a cult. Well, and now let's find out what's happening. All we know so far is that Kaufman seems to know something about this bird or this cult, but he don't want to reveal that to his colleague. Only if we have proof. They're trying to find David. They're coming. Who are you? Yeah, sometimes we have control over other persons. I don't know if that... It's a woman. Okay, I don't know some elderly woman. None of us could prepare for this. Okay. Visions screaming were nearly a warning. Now it's too late. They are coming. Oh yeah, this. Oh yeah, the good intro. I like this music so much. Oh, now it's not outside London. Just other elements, okay. As we can see in this title, crows are a very part of this game, and sometimes I hate these birds. Now, last night I had the nightmare again, but this time it was different. This time he talked to me. Oh, I think this is our psychologist. I already have forgot his name, because he was more like a side figure in season 1. It was the same unknown street, void of any sound and life. Okay. I walked aimlessly as I were lost. Ah, shit! Sorry, I just have brain lag. Who are you? Then, as before, he stood in front of me, gazing unrestedly, like he was expecting something. This time he spoke, "Give me back what he took, nothing else. Give me back what he took." Who? I wonder. Now I have fallen asleep again. What time is it? Dawn already. It is time. Okay. Okay. It was several months since Kaufmann and I had found a mysterious letter in Anthony Beecher's house. A letter never sent with a cryptic warning of what happened if a certain door were opened. I bore only the name of an addressee, Alexander Dupreux. If you're sure, Dupreux? I don't know how to speak this name. Was key to finding my patient and friend, Jemima DeWitt, who had disappeared in such strange circumstances, troubled by the death of his friend Anthony. DeWitt had visited the school of his childhood and had never been seen again. Kaufmann soon conveyed to me his deep concerns and warned that I should conduct any investigation with the utmost discretion. He pursued his own research. Dupreux, okay. Though his thoughts and methods remained a secret, in his last letter he requested that I visit East Hill Lunatic Asylum in London. There were reason to believe that Alexander had been institutionalized there for many years. I was asked to confirm this hypothesis and, if it proved correct, to gather whatever other information might arise. Oh, okay, so now we are playing the psychologist as protagonist. Oh, nice. Huh? That's new! And map! And season 1 was really streamlined. You don't have really much locations. Or a whole London. Okay. Season 2, episode 1, the playwright. So this is East Hill Lunatic Asylum. I hope I can fight him. I can find information on Alexander Dupreux here. See, monster found in what? Here's the dead ambassador. The graphic looks a bit better, but I have taken final or fantastic graphics on the start screen. Ist hier Leute gezogen. Hallo. Good morning, would like to purchase a newspaper. Good morning, boy. Will you give me a newspaper? Yes, sir, it's sixpence. Afraid I don't have sixpence. Can I make change for a shilling? I'm sorry, I can't, sir, but you know where to find me when you have coins. Okay, we need few little coins. Huh. What can you tell me about this building? The sign? I've never been inside and hope I will never will. It's full of crazies, you know. Have you seen anything unusual around here? No, but maybe if you bought a newspaper? Goodbye. Okay. Few cardboard sheets lying on the bench. It shows a perfectly symmetric design in black ink. Good morning. Ah yes, a lovely morning. Sunlight of a quite fascinating character. I beg your pardon? The light makes everything look different. You see, light touches things, soaks into them. It changes their nature. It makes them shimmer or make them die. Do you live here in the hospital? I do indeed. My family is a generous benefactor to East Hill. They had me committed, but I don't blame them. They're just incapable of appreciating my art, or any art, for that matter. They mistake it for insanity. Okay, so he's just a misunderstanding artist. Maybe. What are you drawing there? I'm not just drawing, my friend. I'm trying to feel the light translate its power to the surface of a paper. Most animals don't like it, though. They don't want me to succeed, so they take them away. They take away my drawings and they study them and they laugh because my eyes can see the light and theirs are blind. But someday, what animals? Someday everyone will understand. Who are we? Who wants to take your art away? Ha, those foolish caretakers. They hide behind a big mirror where they think themselves safe and they look at me, they observe me, they even take notes. There's some curious drawings right there beside you. Oh, you mean these? They are the only art that makes any sense here. The doctors use them to cajole some patients into revealing secret inner truths. I won't return them to the doctors under their have returned for art they have stolen from me. Oh, so he has stole the ink blot things. My name is Dr. Wakefield. I'm looking for a man who lived here some time ago. What do you happen to know one Alexander Dupree? The name does not ring a bell. I have not been here long though. You should ask the other patients. They may be able to help you. Some have been here for many years. Or you could ask one of ours, the brutes who keep us here. Would you happen to know where your drawings are now? I suspect they are somewhere in the archives. Some have seen confiscated items taken there before. It seemed different from the rest. Can I trust you? I've been trying to sneak in for days now, but Miss Riswell keeps a tight guard on the door. I stole a key from one of those guards. You're a doctor. Surely you could gain entry. If you could recover my drawings, I would be so grateful. Here, take the key with you. Ooh, nice. Have a nice day. Okay, we have a key, obviously, for this door, I think. What I have to say for season 1, there are some really good riddles, like in episode 2, the priest is already blind, and his floor is cracking. So he just wander around, atoning for his sins and talking to God in his room with too many crucifixes. And you can only move when he moves. Something like that, but it was really cool. The large door is made of strong metal. This must lead to a secure ward of a hospital. Inmate quarters. Oh, it's not for this door, okay. I really like how now there's no music playing. Hello. Good morning, madam. My name is Dr. Wakefield. I'm a psychiatrist. Oh my, good morning. Forgive my manners. I get so excited when we have visitors. We don't have many these days, and certainly we are lacking experts like you. What do you mean? You lack experts? Every year we get less funding from the crown. First, the doctors started to leave when it was for caretakers. Now, very few remain. But we have a responsibility to our poor patients, do we not? We must care for them. They cannot be out living with the proper people. We must keep ourselves safe and our patients too. Of course. I looked for a man who used to be a patient here a few years ago. His name is Alexandre Dupree. Did you perchance ever met him? I said Dupree. Yes, there was one with a foreign name. I remember something of him. A good man, if I recall correctly. An educated man. But there was something strange about him. Wasn't there? I believe it scared some of other patients. You never know with this lot. I'm sorry, but I can't remember much. There have been so many people here, it is hard to keep track. Have you worked here for long? Yes, a long time. I can scarcely remember how many years. Time goes slowly in here, and the isolation rules don't allow us to leave. I don't know what it is happening in the world anymore. But we have our duty, do we not? We have to care for our patients. May I request access to the institute's archives? There should be some information about the man I'm looking for, Mr. Dupree. I'm sorry, Doctor, but the archives are private. We must not allow anyone to access them with the proper authority. Many of our patients come from good families, you see, and we take great care to respect their privacy. But do not look so crestfallen, you would not find much in any case. It is a long time since they have been organized. Yay. Bookshelf. Oh, my nose. Sorry, I feel sneezing. Oh, come on. Sorry. Books are not volumes of security or medical science, but old serial novels for patients to read. Okay. I'm sorry, the archives is off limits. Okay, where are the archives? Can I go over here? Okay, that's okay. This must be the recreational ring. The patient relaxes and passes the time. Perhaps here I can find someone who met Alexander Dupree while he was institutionalized. Oof, this word. He looks like a general or something. A man wearing one-armed military uniform, lost in God knows what forms. Excuse me, sir. I cannot help but notice your uniform. Were you in the army? Leave me alone. You do not want to talk to a coward such as myself. Okay, sir. Leave me alone, I'm just a coward. Okay. Ground decoration of this room suggests a great deal of sensitivity to a patient's moral needs. Okay, who are you? Good morning, madam. My name is Wakefield. I'm looking for a former patient of this institution. For rumbling. She doesn't seem to have noticed me. Have been living here long? Madame, if I may persist, have you been living here long? I'm looking for a former patient of this hospital. You may have met him. An eyeless gaze. I look for a man that you may have met. His name is Alexandre Dupree. Oh. Okay. What a strong reaction upon hearing Mr. Dupree's name. She must have at least met him. How can I get her to talk to me? Why are you? Good morning. I'm a psychiatrist. Dr. Wakefield, quite an impressive institution you have here. Can I ask for your assistance? I'm looking for a former patient of this institution. His name is Dupree. I'm sorry, sir, I never heard that name before. Maybe one of your senior colleagues could know something about this former patient. Well, you could ask Miss Roosevelt in the interest hall. She has been here for years, maybe for too long. You know, we caretakers live here with the patients, and we are not allowed to leave the asylum's premises. What the fuck? This life can get to you if you don't take proper care. I try to keep as much distance as possible from the lunatics. Wow! What times? There are not many patients. The asylum is quite big, but I can't help noticing there aren't many patients around. Well, apart from those in the isolation ward, it is true that there are not many patients at present, but there are even fewer of us caretakers now. We are only three for the whole hospital. What I've been told in the old times, the income was enough to provide for everything we needed. Complete staff, proper accommodation for the patients, and the best doctors. But as the newer, bigger, original asylums were built, the crowd support was gradually withdrawn from ISIL. Soon everyone started leaving. And this is what remains. Okay. I'm a little stupid from work. What is this door? Okay. Share circle. Oh! It's a big mirror! Ooh. There's a thin piece of metal holding the window open. What the fuck? What? Darkest room is now, I can see through the false mirror. It's false mirror, oh, okay. What the fuck? There's a man on the other side, heavily restrained, desperately trying to free himself. It's an expression of unbearable horror on his face. That's jar full of transparent liquid that may or may not be water. Where's the coin resting at the bottom? Half a shilling. That's 6 pence. Yes. Sorry, guy, but I need my newspaper. So maybe I can trade it with one of the staffs for information or items. So we'll get something out from outer world. I would like a newspaper. 6 pence it is. Is it? Here. Thank you, sir. Okay, let's read it. Today's illustrated London news. The first headline is about a grim case. Scotland Yard keeps it silent about the ambassador of Turkey found dead last Saturday under mysterious circumstances. Okay. Our source is suspect. He may have been murdered. The second, a sea monster found in St. Eves. The remains of a serpent from the deep were found on the beach early yesterday morning. It is suspected they come from a seaside museum in Spain, destroyed a month ago by the sea waves during the terrifying storm. There's another drawing. Advertising an operator called Love Brush Strokes. Okay. Let's give her the newspaper. Why, thank you kindly, how thoughtful you are. So, goodbye, dear lady. This hospital archive, where a record of each patient must be stored. If Mr. Dupree was really committed at Isil, his file should be here somewhere. Okay, what is this? It's been a long time since Miss Death was last used. It is covered in the discarded papers and pens and a noticeable layer of dust. Doors are all locked. This chemical contains many documents detailing the treatment of patients ranging from 2 decades ago to last year. His file is right here. Dupree, Alexandra, room 108A. All the files are missing. It is as if they had been torn out. Only a little piece of paper remains with an address written on it. Paul Street 26. Could it be where Alexander Dupree lived before he was committed to his hospital? Paul Street. I shall follow this new lead and see if it takes me somewhere useful. Okay. That's really new, this whole map thing. And reminds me somewhat of Sherlock games. Piece of metal. Okay. A metal locker. A small sign reads "Seize objects." Heh. Some personal effects. Probably sent in by the patient's families, but deemed unsafe by the caretakers. One of them is a stack of thick sheets of paper, carelessly bound together, bearing the drawings and paintings of a troubled mind. Let's look at it. Watercolor paintings and drawings of different subjects, a tree, a vase, flowers, something that could be a portrait. with a callous art dispersed, shapes broken, decomposed, and mixed in a whirl of bright flecks. Well, it's art. I would say. So, I never was here. Okay, here your drawings. Yeah, with the drawings. Great wonder, we are back. Someday we will understand light and shape as I understand them. Thank you, friend. If you want, take these cardboard sheets. Thanks to you, I have no more need of them. Yeah, it's ink blots. if you fold a cardboard jeans, it one with a large symmetric patch of black ink in the middle. I've heard of this technique, but always thought it an essential to see. Patients are supposed to see in the deeper course of the ailment. This is the first card. A two-headed butterfly. Maybe. Shape looks organic. Yeah, something like an ant, maybe? Almost like insects. This looks like a scarabee. Oh, there's white corkins here. I would say this could be a face. Well, I have no clues what to do with it, so I take carriage. To Paul Street! Oh, okay, this looks like some of the first season places. The door is number 24, I'm looking for 26, and maybe this door. Number 24, this is the place I'm looking for, but the door is bricked up, I must find another way in. Windows are fully cemented over, that is almost mixes with the facade. Okay. The ruins of an old chapel apparently destroyed by fire. And who plays for organ? A mess of wooden planks and remains of benches and chairs. And oh, a crow or a raven. I don't understand it really because it's really not really loud. There's someone on their knees praying. The face is covered by a hood. The wooden cross remains almost intact. An improvised altar covered by encampment. I can light my way through the dark. Okay. First thing, we almost have an oil lamp. This guy. Get a candle. Okay. Looks like the soul leads to the building next door. Okay. must be the interior of a bricked-up building I saw on the street. Mr. Dupree's former residence. Okay. I cannot tell who is depicted in the portrait, since it is so badly damaged. I assume someone crushed it into the floor. The door is bricked up. There's something wrong with the ashes. It's a piece of paper. Oh, oh shit. This club of students, David and Co. It's it was like a secret philosophy club. And they always said something in Latin, but I don't remember it. It's like some kind of message, but there is only one half there. Here. The paper has been carefully burned. There's a piece of paper on the table. That shows some very seemingly random letters. It seems as half of it is missing. We can combine them? With that, I have to put both halves back together, but some letters seem to be missing from the right half. The message does not make any kind of sense. What's this? A military medal. There's a relief of Her Majesty the Queen and several pieces of metal engraved. The names of medals unknown to me. I will take this with me. Maybe if it means something to one of Alexander's fellow patients in the hospital. Yeah, to the general, like one man in a high rank uniform. He's missing an arm. Okay. Just to check if I don't read shit. Because I'm a bit foggy. Or dizzy. To a certain. Few books remain on the shelf, mostly down for trilogies in chemistry and alchemy. Among the titles are Trifimius, Delapid, Philosophical, Gebus, De Inventione, Veritatis, Animus Work, Tobor, Philosophus Forum, and Luffy Prince, Mysteries of the World. We have found, or. Yeah, I think we have found and know that Alexander have someone to work for him as alchemist. Or to get alchemistic insight, give information about it. Large metal safe. So the safe is working fine. I should give it a try. Oh. Okay, the numbers are from 1 to 8. But... we are no... oh! We are numbers, but... only in the left part. There's a 6 and a 5. But what is something more is missing? Okay, let's try it. But I don't know if left or right. Six, and... oh! It worked. But, as I thought, I have not enough information. Can I open the map every time? I don't know. Okay, let's go there to get to the map screen. Yes. What I really miss is that I can't double click to enter each area, just some areas. What general is here? I think it's in general. It's metal. I had one just like this. Got it after battles of Laren Neck at Majuba Hill in 1881. So 10 years ago. A decade ago now. What does Kingridge conduct with here? It said. English contact with you. What a farce. So you were in the army, as I thought. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Dr. Wakefield. Sergeant William Conghill. Her Majesty's 6th Light Infantry. Okay. I am another one of those alienists. Huh? What? Do your daughters not realize that cowardice cannot be cured by your arts? Wait, arts? Why are we keeping you here? Just a moment. Doctors say I have suffered from a nervous disorder. Okay. I believe this is a term for when they themselves overlearning. Don't know what to say. But I know the true name of my sickness. It's pure cowardice. I'm looking for a former patient of this hospital. You may have met him. His name is Vincent Dupree. Yes, I did know a man by that name. We met briefly. He was here when I arrived. What do you know about him? He was a proper lad, educated. He listened closely to the stories of other inmates, but he kept his own to himself. He talked a lot. He was very close to Miss Coney. Miss Coney? Too. I think they got here at the same time. But when he left, he did so alone. I wonder what has become of him since. Just answer my sister. Who's this, Miss Coney? His patient here, the lady with a temptationist character. You may have encountered her already. She has not been the same since Mr. Dupree left, you know? She always sits to my side, alone and silent. I doubt you could talk to her at all. If you try, she sees things, or at least she thinks she does. Was haben wir? I must read in my other check window. What did you talk about, Mr. Priet? Yes, but what? What did you talk about, you and Mr. Dupree? I talked about my time in the south of Africa. I don't like to talk about that, but he's how it made me want to. He was a bit swear of this. Very interested in one specific story, almost as savage about it. He wanted to know every little detail. Could you tell me your story? I'm trying to find a patient of mine who has gone missing. This could be my only hope of finding him. I don't like to leave those memories. A missing patient, you say? Alright. Maybe my story will be of some use then. It happened during the Battle of Majuba Hill. I'm sure you have heard of it in March of 81. The attack of a Boer army had taken us by surprise, and our regiment was forced to split up. We quickly found ourselves alone, just a few men lost on the barren plain. But I don't want to bore you. No, sir, you certainly aren't. Please continue. Oh. As I said, we were few and we were sure the enemy has lurking out there. With a cold air of dusk. A thick fog formed quickly, masking everything around us. We could barely see each other. Ooh, did I play it now? Well, we see it. Okay. Oh, that reminds me of the fog at the end of episode 4. The veil. Oh! I just thought we were one of the guys who was walking. When we all started to disappear in the fog, it was getting thicker. I could still hear the footsteps for a while when noticing nothing. Ugh, it's. Ugh, it's too fast. So. I felt something in there not far, a murmur beating, something alive, waiting for us. I get. All of a sudden, my feet felt something in the mud. A body. It was. Ooh. Okay. These are the Boer people? I haven't reached the whole settlement. And the mist cleared out. What had happened? If I knew for certain, I didn't see anything. Or if I did, my mind refused to bear such memories. What happened to Captain Skid? Okay, Captain Skid was maybe mentioned in a later sentence, but. Time to read it. When you finally regain consciousness, it was like someone else looked out at us through his eyes. I guess whatever affected him changed him. Oh, that's something similar to the whole Anthony Beechworth case. Because his wife and servants have discredited letters that he changed, he was not the same person. Like, he's possessed. And now he came back to London. Mr. Dupree asked me of his whereabouts. Maybe tried to contact him to hear the rest of the story. He was quite preoccupied by it. Do you know where I can find Captain Skid? The last I heard from fellow veterans, he had lost himself to a frenzy of alcohol, opium, and bad company. This downward spiraled him. This downward spiral led him, as many others, to a wretched nadir. A dirty hole deep in St. Giles' rookery, known as the Crimson Nest. Mayhap you will find him there, alive, even if you're lucky. Here, this is a picture of our regiment. You can see him there. I think it's the person. The third person from the right. Okay. Another location. Huh. But what about her? Miss Connie is very upset. Please do not distress her further. What a strange reaction upon hearing Mr. Priest's name. Yeah, ink blots. Okay. Huh. Okay, let's go find Skid. So I'm not just at my higher times. The scene will not be very long, too. I think, like, maybe 10:30. Oh! This is the slum of Sangha, as the Crimson has shipped in before. That's something we have seen in the intro. The glow of a street lamp casts a comforting glow on an otherwise empty street. This man looks like the man from my nightmares. He is blind in one eye. The empty socket listens in the lamplight. It seems to want something from me. In my dream, the man had said, give me back what he took. What he took? What he... Artist had took the ink blots. Photograph. It doesn't look right, anyone of his picture. I doubt it has ever been his. Give me what he took. He said in my nightmare. Piece of metal? He took. Okay. So maybe I must do something with the safe first. But how? Let me think. We have two numbers so far. 6 and 5. You've done something wrong. Wait, it was mask. Are you kidding me? It was a fucking mask. Or not? If I dreamt it. Also smart. We need from a can has revealed a set of letters painted with invisible ink. Now it's better. So it's 6. Maybe from left to right, top to down. Also 6, 1, 4, 5. It is empty. Wait, this is not a safe, but an entrance to a passage. What? It is completely dark. The only way to know where it leads is by crawling in. Okay. What the fuck is happening here? With magic formulae written fast and carelessly, some of these symbols I have never seen before. A list of numbers, it looks like some kind of Canada timetable. What the fuck is this machine? Who the fuck are you? Is that dream built out of wood, steel, and glass? I wonder what extension could be. What the fuck is this? Is someone sitting here wearing a horrible mask on a yellow robe? He's not moving. Okay, no head. It's only a yellow robe. There is nobody inside at all. What could be the meaning of this? What? Oh fuck, there's someone coming. Fuck.
Bellissima Virgo Maria, non esaudi più ne sai culo, qua in alta tua corrente in prazia, tu imperante in auxilia, tu pretente in suffragiese della
vita.
Zölle? Ich nehme die Konfidenz a te, Virgo Virginium, Mater Currimus, Acte Venimus, Curane Gementes.
Ja, laber mich nicht voll. Tschüss. Ich verstehe es eh nicht. Holy shit, warum labert die mich jetzt voll? Weil das war hier. Betfrau. Was war die denn jetzt? War da vielleicht die Maschine, die das Serum herstellt? Aber ich habe diese Apparatur da mit der Robe und der Maske nicht ganz verstanden. Aber vielleicht ist die Maske ja etwas, was wir dem Typen geben müssen. Ich verstehe aber wohl noch nicht ganz, was ich hiermit mache. Looks to Mars for a second. What is there at me again? Keep it right, he took. He said in my nightmare. Fuck, it's not it. Wait, we never tried to just go past him. Okay, we can go past. Maybe we can go with a mask to East Hill and show that to the lady? What the fuck? She attacked me. This was an award for you this time. The face of a playwright. What the fuck happened? It is all that only this window shuttered. The curtains cast a mottled shadow over this corner of a room. Can I? Oh. What the fuck? It's here. Oh. He's free. Okay. A man is striking the glass strongly with his fist. His expression is of pure hate. I don't think he can see me, but I feel that somehow he knows I'm here. Let him free. Oh. Mars. Can I open the window again? Okay. Huh? Ha. Hello, I've done nothing wrong. Beziehungsweise nur ganz, ganz wenig. Aber ich glaube, ich weiß, worauf du anspielst. Dieses, oh, was war das? Die Tochter, Schwester von Moriarty-Ding? Weißt du das? Die auch in der im Hochsicherheitsgefängnis Klapse eigentlich sitzen soll? Poor woman. Wie gesagt, ich habe glaube ich nur die Folge mal gesehen und mal erst so vereinzelt. Ich habe es jetzt nicht so krass verfolgt. We must have taken her to the realization board. Ich weiß nur, war eine nette Idee, was wir da gemacht haben. Wir wollten mal nicht für alles spoilern. So. Okay, what's going on in here? Why is this here so dark? Oh, room 108A it was. What? It's bricked. What the fuck? Why is this bricked? Close clothes were good with bricks. Like we were pretending it never existed. We didn't even try to disguise it. What the fuck? A bunch of bricks. Human construction is recent. And not yet finished. Or we were in a hurry to see this room. Ventilation cells. Door shut unlocked. There's no way to open it. Why can't I open this? That looks normal. That's a looking piece of furniture. There's nothing on it. The press is from painting of a lovely maiden. It's equipped with a fitting magnificent frame. It's a bed. There's nothing special about it. A mirror covered in dust. I wonder what things has it seen in this room. Okay. Why can I open this shit? Okay. An old pendant on the dresser, it looks valuable. I take it. An old tarnished silver pendant. Oh, maybe this is what we need to give this strange guy. Oh, I don't want to, but. Please not the. Who are you and. What the fuck? Are you... Huh? Not much like managed to reach this room. Hello? My name is Wakefield. The butterfly is not what it seems. Excuse me, but what butterfly? There's more after the scarab. Oh, fake blood. Is this the butterfly you talked about? At the place? It's a place, it's wonderful colors, fills your eyes with awe. But this is only a show behind the veil. Its body crawls on the dirty ground, hides in the darkness, and transforms another of its lies. So what would this be? It's dark but it creases, muscles with its blind movement, slowly, step by step. It's closer and closer and closer. What about this one? It will come, whatever you do, it will cry out loud, looking at you from everywhere at the same time. And what about this one? Him. Him? His mask, my maid from the other room, used to scream at night. Told us he could feel something under his bed, a presence, an eyeless gaze. Under his bed? Oh, fuck me. Let's look under the bed. Wait. Oh. So he means this room? The room of a patient's maid who was afraid of a presence under his bed. What the fuck? So, where was someone under his bed? Oh, it was a sender. Okay. The door is rigged up. Why would they do such a thing? The window is sealed too. Almost no light can reach the room. There's something written on the wall. One of them came last night. I knew what it would. What it actually was because of a sign it carried. A sign of an eye. I killed it. I hid it well. If more come, we will not find the friend nor its eye. Okay. I doubt anyone has slept in this place for a long time. Is there something else? No. And get out of here. I still have no use for this shit. But maybe now I can give a pendant. Is this the only time I have a plan? Does not seem to understand. Give me back what you took. Ugh, Krishnach! What do you mean? Okay, have you finished missions at Paul Street? I don't think so. I hope so, because this strange woman was strange and she's not talking my language. So it must be something at East Hill. It must have something to do with the guy on the top, I think. Where's this door? Actually. Oh, a ferrity log. Edward Rowan, 27. Acute dementia. September 25, 1891. Mr. Rowan's condition has degenerated since the last session. He's restless, as if a morphine had no effect on him. For last week, he has been obsessive, troubled for reasons unknown. Patient's dosage has been doubled to no effect. Dr. Waddell has been attacked and bitten in the face. Ooh. Four men were needed to subdue the patient. Mr. Rowan, three markings were found on his body upon examination. Self-harm is possible, of course. Mr. Rowan is getting better day by day, both physically and mentally. His habits have changed considerably. He now shows interest in religion and spends his time murmuring prayers. Albert, once unknown to my colleagues and me. Oh shit. Goodbye. I'm a little clueless now, to be honest. Good. Who is he? And what did he take? And what to do with this necklace, pendant? this metal piece. Can I talk to you again? Light of Lumber Wood with Shades. Okay. Let's talk with Mr. Wayne Man. His master mage from our room used to scream at night. Yeah, I know. And I have fired nothing more than this. Message. But will come after us. Okay. Huh. So back to. Sorry. Back to what was it? Paul Street. Maybe I can do something with a necklace there? She's not here anymore. What? The machine has stopped. Where did she go? Okay, so she was not important, maybe? Four shares form a cycle. As if a hideout served as some sort of meeting place. Huh. Oh, okay, that's nothing. To be honest, I have no clues what to do with my current items. Because I don't have anything. Oh wait, I have tried the pendant on the inmate. Shit, I don't remember. I don't think so. Back to the asylum. Little try and error. First direction. Shit. I have no idea. Maybe I can talk to Miss Rockwell. How was the name? Rizwell? Woman staying at the resolution. Yeah. Do you know something about that? There's something I know about this. God damn it. I feel really stuck. Hmm. What to do with a metal piece? And with his mask? Huh? And what did he took? And who's he? Vielleicht kann der mir noch was hinaus something. But the asylum. Alright, you know where always voices coming from the place at night. Crying, singing, inhabitants, cursing like damn souls. That's the usual. This night was different. It was all silent, I tell you. Not a single noise in the whole street. I looked at the madhouse and saw all the windows black, no lights. Everybody asleep in the place? Now it's strange. When I heard it, it was a scream like no other I've ever heard. Not a man or a woman, but a devil from hell. What? That's very curious indeed. Thank you for telling me. Sure. Goodbye, boy. Well, it doesn't help me. Maybe he means me and the candle? So I have no clues. But the only thing in this hidden room was, in the asylum, was this message. There was no item. I have checked everything. I think this is a call for a walkthrough because I'm really stuck and I don't know shit. So I will search for walkthrough and search for pixels. Let's go to the cell just one more time, and then I will look it up. What direction? Not that I'm missing a location or something. Okay. I think this door was. No, only a message. I will look it up. Because I don't know shit. What's we do? What's we do? It's the safe thing. Gotta read something about this room, but I'm not sure this is important. Like, there's some creaking. But maybe it's just the secrets. Okay, maybe it's just for the secret. If we missed, show the man the cards, blah blah blah. Okay. I haven't seen something. So are you kidding me? Ugh. Okay, that's stupid. I mean, it could have been the bat who makes the shadow and then the light goes on. So, ugh. It seems one of his ties is loose. So. Let's have them half buried with salt under the tile. It's a long dead bird, as feathers and bones. Just holding something in its beak. A dirty and horrible deformed glass eye. Ugh. Okay. That must be the thing I was looking for. But... oh! He was described as one-eyed person. But if you don't find this, you don't have clues about what the fuck did he want. Okay, now I play without... walkthrough. So, here's your glass eye. Thanks for nothing. Ugh. Okay. This must be the Crimson Nest. I've heard of such places. The people lose their minds to opium shipped from the Orient. I never thought I would set foot in one. A small window casts a little light into the alley. There's something disheartening about its feeble glow. Yay! Nice. Let's look up to you. And I'm completely asleep. What is the matter, madam? My husband, he's unconscious. Please, dear, wake up. I'm a doctor. Please let me see him. I'm so sorry. He's not breathing. He has no pulse. Your husband passed away hours ago. No, 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 it can't be. Madam, I'm late. This time I couldn't save him. What do you mean this time? I've discovered my husband's addiction to this hellish drug, like opium, months ago. At first I thought he was sick, as I saw him grow thinner every day. Then I discovered he was visiting this place. I was very worried. I tried to dissuade him, but he wouldn't listen. The addiction was stronger than he was. At times he was away for days. I would come here and find him passed out. Only way I could wake him was to put his smelling salts under his nose. Mmm, nice. Now it's too late. Here, take the wine. Maybe you will be in time to save another soul from this curse. Thanks, I guess. The man with a lost gaze, his mouth open. A woman looking at the roof with her eyes going wild. She's muttering some ramblings. The musician is intoxicated with the black smoke that fills the air. The repeated arrangement gives the sensation that time flows slowly. Wow, what a place. Short-haired woman walking without worry. A man lying on his back, his breathing rasping and layered with phlegm and other liquids. The smoke has eaten away his lungs. This young couple seems to have come here together to enjoy the impeccable vice. Hello, I'm looking for a man who I believe Frankens is a testament. A war veteran from the south of Africa called Skid. He's right on the slate. On the slate. Can you understand what I'm saying? It was written, can't hear. Wow. So I suppose I should communicate with him by writing on his slate. Looking for Captain Skid. Don't know. He doesn't know the captain's name then. He's written something else. Object of value. What does he mean by that? Ah, yeah, it's him about the penner. So, sorry for German, but he annoys me. Oh shit, is this the captain? Oh no, he looks dead. There were several option pipes on top. Some of them have been used recently. Shiny screen with floral ornament. It's Captain Skid, no doubt. He's unconscious, but he still breathes. Wake up! What's the matter? Who let you in? Get out! My name is Wakefield. I need to talk to you. Are you Captain Skid? Her Majesty's Six Light Infantry. The title belongs to me no more. Who are you and what do you want from me? Leave me alone with my misery. A soldier that used to serve under your command told me I might find you here. William Conhill. Yes, a rebel man. We served together. I've made many mistakes trying to forget those years of my life. Now I'm afraid those memories will follow me to my grave. I'm looking for information about a man called Alexandre Dupree. I used to know Dupree. He was not a man, but a fiend. Oh, okay. What do you want with someone like him? There are certain secrets that are better left undisturbed. A patient of mine has disappeared, and Zendra is the only one that may know his whereabouts. If it is true that Dupree is involved in your patient's disappearance, then I'm afraid the matter is out of my reach. Yours too. Now please leave me alone. Have you ever heard the name Jeremiah DeWitt? I must find him. wit. No, I have not. I found your medal. It was in a house on Paul Street, door 26. You were there, right? I think you know what you're doing, but you cannot imagine what you're getting into. I'm asking you for the last time. Leave or forget this matter. I will not leave until I find the answers I'm seeking. Tell me what I want to know. You fool. That's... for devil's sake, alright. If you want to ruin your life, you are free to do it. What really happened on Majuba Hill? Sergeant Conker told me the story, but his details were confusing. I will never be able to forget that day. Nobody knew what really happened. Command decided that we must have been ambushed. Now I know better. There was something Red Fog, something that did not like us entering its domain, a sentinel of some sort. That thing is what killed my soldiers. Ooh, the bird, or the eye of a bird killed. I forgot the name. Like Salan Terhal or something like that. How did you meet Alexander Dupree? I was in the veterans hospital, recovering from an illness unknown to the physicians. At ailment of a soul, Dupree managed to contact me there. He wanted to know my version of the story, what happened to me in the Battle of Majuba Hill. Do you know why he was interested in your story? I didn't know immediately, but with time I realized the truth about what happened to me was important to his activities, as was I myself. But if you think he tricked me, you could not be more wrong. I wanted to enter the dragon's mouth. I burned with a need to know. Okay. At 7 hours I saw a machine separating. What was that? A machine? I do not know what you're talking about. It was just one of many places used as a base for Alexandria's activities. The only one whose location I was allowed to know. Okay. What was Mr. Bree doing then? You really do not know, do you? Have you ever heard of a playwright? I have never heard. Yeah, well, we have from. Yes, I've heard it mentioned before. What is it? Oh, story. As I mentioned, you know nothing. Dupree is not alone, but he is. The peak of a pyramid, a vast group in which powerful people take a part. Ooh, the cult. So, playwright is the name of a cult? Society acting in secret and ruled by a single sacred law. See that no one knows. I was part of it. Dupree himself recommended. We gathered every month. What we saw, you cannot imagine. Curtain of normalcy protects the mind from something, an outer something. The fog of a veil protected us. By full away, we could peek out into the abyss. We could know of the unspeakable shapes, what rather beyond, a black nothingness. Entirely full of horrors. We could never cross the threshold. What we saw was forbidden. Look at me, forbidden. I could not bear it anymore, so I ran. I ran and hid from them. Huh. It was too late to run. Or to forget. What? Must go back to Issa and try to talk to Miss Coney. If what the captain said is true, she must have been one of them. She could know where to find them. What's happening? What the fuck? I cannot do this anymore. I don't care, I just want us to be together. You know it's too hard, I don't feel like it. I know, dear, I know we will figure it out now. How are you, Holmes? Are you all along? How could you? Oh, we'll talk about it later. You know, you never loved each other. Silence, you have no honor. And yo, what do you have to say? Why? I have given you everything. You wouldn't understand, I... Enough. You will leave nothing. I won't see you ever again. I will wait for you at dawn, under the old windmill, so you can try to recover what little honor you have. I will be there. What happened to him? I must have fainted. What is this? Where am I? So, to what happened there? In the first season, we have heard a story of a white rabbit. We have encountered a wolf, a snake, and a wild vulture. All three predators wanted to eat it. And the rabbit was smart and has tricked them into a race. So, to decide who should be allowed to eat the rabbit. As they started, he goes to the opposite direction and was hit by a meteor, or the meteor hit the whole earth or something. And where the story ends. And then there was a jump scare with people in rabbit costumes and was really creepy. And now we have also here the snake, wolf, and vulture. So it's a continuation of this story. It has something to do with it. Where am I? Shit, isn't this the silent room? Or one of the silent rooms? I can see outside clearly. A matchbox. This could be useful. An old piece of furniture. There are marks in the dust on the floor. It looks like the chair has been moved recently. Shifting the chair revealed a small dark hole in the wall. A small hole in the wall, it's too dark to see inside. The door is shut for good and it has no knob. No key or even. Toll. Nice. Fuck. It's black in the bed. I take a shred of his blanket. Okay, can I take anything else? Okay, matches or blanket? I would swear I saw a pair of feet in there. Who was there? we have met before. I cannot see you. Who are you? Do you not recognize my voice? No, I'm sorry, I do not. Do you know what this place is? It is the starting point, the first place to look. But who are you? What are you doing here? Remember this, I will not be here forever. Darkness will light the way. Stay out of the light when I will disappear, and you will be alone in the end. I don't understand. Tell me who you are. I can hear brushing behind the wall. That is not rude. I must take it with me. Only the magic remains. Oh, maybe he means to darken the room. What the fuck? The door, shit. Again, now. Okay. David, is that you? David! Who? To David? Okay. Oh, shit. Okay. Fuck. Blood. No, talk to us. Okay. Tell me, why are you doing this? Is it because you care about your patients? Or out of scientific curiosity? Is it for your pride? Because it is your professional responsibility? Or is it because it is the right thing to do? Why are you doing this? Johann Kaufmann! No, David! It's alright, mein lieber Freund. How are you feeling? Oh, that must be so difficult for only English people. With, what the fuck is he telling? Fucking German! I feel dizzy. What happened? Where are we? At my house. I went to East Hill to meet you and found you inside one of the cells. Unconscious, your clothes stenching of opium smoke. I have. Right, it was one of the cells. I had you brought here. You have been out for a day and a half. I think it's coming back to me. I was at one of those opium dens. I have passed out after breathing with dense smoke. Doesn't have much to tell you. My investigation unearthed a great deal of new information. Alexander was indeed institutionalized in Isir, but his files were missing. I managed to track down a man who knew him. He told me a story you would not believe, and there was this woman, a patient at the hospital. She was completely out of her mind. She attacked me. What is happening to these people, Kaufmann? How is this exactly related to Mr. DeWitt? I think this patient, Miss Coney, might know how to find Alexandra. We must go back there and talk to her, whatever it takes. I'm afraid it will not be possible. Oh shit, she's dead. What do you mean? Falcone is no longer at East Hill. She escaped last night. Oh, she escaped. Okay. God almighty. Do not worry, my friend. I think I may know where she is hiding. Get ready. We must leave promptly. Okay. Oh, episode 1 done? Oh, no, okay. We are coming. We are letting him in. Now that the door has been opened. We are coming. Are we? Ah! Oh fuck! Swarm of crows. Okay. They are coming. Oh, it's the playwright was created. Ah, okay. That's the ending. So I will call it a day here because I'm really dizzy and tired. So episode 2 will be continued next week. Because I have not planned it in this week. Painting description by schwarzes Licht. Well, it's a nice start. I somehow like the new things, like this map and but we are now not David. But the other side was searching for them. But with floor tile riddle was something. Ugh. I thought interesting. Yeah, Groby. So let's see who can we raid with a mini raid. Oh, we are raiding Myth because she's playing one of my favorite games, The Eye of a Dragon. Wish you all a good night and bye for Tiger. So, good night. Good night.